Well, Brian Bury and Aussie TV legend rose to fame as the original madcap weatherman, and even though the loud bow ties and glasses are retired, Brian is as quirky and lovable as ever. Yesterday, Craig Bennett caught up with Brian to chat about old times and the disappointment of losing his TV job after decades in the industry. Here's a bit of a recap.
So where did you and those fabulous bow ties and those wonderful glasses and your weatherman persona come from?
Well, I thought, if you're going to stand out in the crowd here, kid, you've got to do something. People liked what I did, but management didn't.
Is that right?
Oh, I got up their nose. They really didn't dig what I was doing at all.
Murphy's Law is applying here today again, folks, in the Golden West, late thunderstorms in the Midwest and 40.
Why did you quit? Why did you leave showbiz?
I had no choice.
Really?
Well, how?
You?
Yeah, well.
The fabulous Brian Bury?
It was a mutual agreement. At 9, they said, you're fired, and I said, OK.
Right.
Yeah, well, that was
so
a...
So that's how it was.
Well, yeah, it was.
Hello, everyone. I hope I'm still welcome.
And then 7 picked me up after that, and I did it for a while, and then they had a bit of a management change and tiddly to me.
Was it a bit disappointing, really, Brian?
Yes, it was. I was hurt. I really was.
And behind the fun and the laughs lies a family secret. Now, for the first time, the story Brian wants to share with Australia as we bring you part two of his compelling interview.
People see your life as so fabulous and wonderful, an incredible career, beautiful marriage to your wife Margaret.
53 years. Mm-hmm. You don't get that for murder, do you?
But yet you've been touched by a terrible tragedy in the passing of your granddaughter.
Yeah, yes.
What happened, Brian?
My son's younger daughter took her own life, only recently actually, and it's a devastation. You know, my son and his wife, Eva, it's devastating for them and their elder daughter, Nikita. It was terrible that they had to live through it. And then we as grandparents, Marg and I and Peter and Janice on Eva's side, grandparents should never have to bury their grandchildren. We say it about parents, and that's sad too, but the day of the funeral, the four of us, I thought, it's not right that we should be seeing this little one off.
How old was she?
15. 15. And she hadn't begun to live. She hadn't scratched the surface of living, you know.
What happened?
Who knows? I think of the words from South Pacific. Who can explain it? Who can tell you why? Fools give you reasons. Wise men never try. And you can't. There's why. But do you know, a frightening statistic in youth suicide, and Matthew and his friends are going to form a foundation to research into why it happens. 2,500 teenagers commit suicide every year in Australia. That's higher than the road toll, the national road toll.
It's an epidemic.
It's frightening. It worries me that so much pressure is put on these kids today. This is a frightening statistic when you think about what's happening to Australian kids. And what would they have done given a chance to live? What would they have contributed to this nation?
Was there any signs, Brian, that she had troubles?
None at all. She was a good student. She was one of those children that you would say, oh, you'll have to study for this. And she didn't, but she passed. She was a good athlete. She was a good cross-country runner.
She had a lot of friends?
She had a lot of friends. There were 200 people at Tasha's funeral. All the boys and girls from her school were there. It was very moving. It was very sad. And was a tribute to her that they turned up. I remember asking, was she bullied? They said, far from it. She was the one people liked.
So how did your family rally? How do you deal with something like that?
You just gird up your loins and keep going. It's hard for Matt and Eva. That's the thing, you know, it's terribly hard. There's no answer. And that's it, there's no answer. But there may be an answer if the funds can be found to be able to do the research for the people who've got the PhDs in this sort of human behaviour, to unlock the key to it, perhaps.
This is the first time I've ever been on television with you.
I know.
What's the secret to your 53 years, do you think?
I just think we get on well together. We don't have any egos between the two of us, but Brian always is considerate to me. I mean, we might discuss something. For the home, I never interfered with work, although I watched him all the time on the Mike Walsh show. And he really entertained me. I'd be sitting there having my lunch watching the Mike Walsh show when Brian was comparing. And he was entertaining me, I'd laugh. We liked the same things. The only time when you'd come out on the Mike Walsh show, when you first came out, you'd be so nervous you'd speak too quickly. And I just said, slow it down. He was all right after the first commercial break.
Story. And if you or anyone you know needs help, don't hesitate to contact Lifeline on 131114. It's a 24-hour number and it's open for help at any time.